1995 Holden Rodeo TF, lower ball join replace. These days I'm using pine sleepers to, you know, as a safety measure. So that's my system there. The other wheel is on the ground, and the rear wheel is chocked with bricks. So far I've got the cotter pin out. The nut was like that. I've spun it around and put it on just to protect the thread. And I've used this heavy hammer, and I hit it down. It took a fair amount of time. I put some WD-40 on it and it did release. So that is now done. So I'll just put, I'd like to put that back on there. This will spin, but if you put it back and shove it right up, you'll be able to, should be able to get the nut off. It looks like the penetrating oil has seeped right down. I'll clean some of that off to tighten it up. Now, I have released this nut behind the caliper. So there's a nut behind the caliper, and then I'm able to bend this hydraulic hose, if I can just find it back there. Just trying, okay, there we are. So I've bent the bracket back, and that allows the tension to get off the hydraulic hose. And I can now rotate this, and I'm now up to, there's the ball joint, lower ball joint there. There's the top ball joint that has been replaced, but this one has got a split. I might be able to show that split. There it is there. And that could be an original ball joint, I don't know, but let's get this cotter pin out and release this ball joint. Now, to undo the Kessel nut on this control arm, I used a 20mm socket and a ratchet spanner. And for around the back, to release that big bolt there, sorry, at first, to undo the this bolt here, I used a pipe, fairly long pipe, and threaded that onto the end there, and I was able to get that loose. And to remove this big caliper bolt, I had to use an extension, and I was able to get enough leverage on it that way with the pipe. So to release the tension on the hydraulic hose, so that's the bracket there, and I did bend that bracket down, because funnily enough that bracket actually goes down to the second bolt there underneath. So there's one, let's see if I can just locate that. So yeah, that's a bit hard to see, but that's one bolt there, and then further up is the other one. Okay, so because when you turn the Kessel nut here, this will rotate this way, so I have to provide room, and this bracket is still in the way. So I have to remove the bottom nut here and just get this bracket out of the way. I've just broken the ball joint Kessel nut loose, so I've got this the socket on this extension bar here, and I've got this other extension bar that'll slip over fairly long, and so I was able to break that one free. So now I think we have to turn this and work from the other side. So we now have this arm here, And what I did in the last video with the other ball joint was I jacked this up and I released it by hitting on the bottom of the ball joint there. Just try and film that on the bottom there and lifting this one up. I'm not sure if I filmed it or not, but I do have chocks under the front as well as behind the jack, and the rear wheel's chocked. Okay, as you can see, the jacks, this area here has been jacked up a fair way. That's gone up an extra, nearly a block width. Okay, so just to summarize it, this will not release until there's enough pressure. So the pressure is supplied by jacking this area here up. So that's just released. So what I'll do now is I'll let the pressure off this swing arm here and remove the ball joint. So on top, I think we've got two nuts on top, but then this radius rod comes around, and underneath it's a different story. So they're the two nuts that we looked at before, and these screw up from the bottom, I think. So how I released it was, again, putting stacks of pressure on that area here, and I had this big mallet you can get from Bunnings or somewhere like that. And I just hit it on the bottom edge here, or, you know, as vertically as possible. Okay, you have to watch out that you don't hit there. It's not going to cause any real damage, but it's best to hit it direct. I was wearing hearing protection, so okay, this is good. That means that I can get on with the job. Okay, now we can see the travel that the jack was moved up. It was probably extended twice the height that it is now. You really do have to jack this up and put a lot of stress on the ball joint for it to release. It's quite incredible. No wonder they never come off vehicles or anything like that. Okay, the nut is off the top, and now we'll just bring it down safely. Okay, now to remove the ball joint. Okay, so at the moment, all top and lower ball joints are done on the rodeo. I can't film it with the camera there. There we go. Okay, I was having some problems getting the ball joint out, and then I noticed this here. You may be able to see, I'll just focus that. You may be able to see here that it seems to have had an impact. It just will not focus. May be able to see there that has been hit up just on the edge there, and it's blocking that from coming out. Okay, I gave it a good swift hit with the socket extension on the edge there, and now it'll come straight out. So that's what we were looking at. That's fairly good now. Okay, so there's the new one. Now I'm pretty sure that this was replaced, and that's why I got a set of, so I would have got one ball joint, and then I would have got a set, because there would have been other cut rubbers and etc. But I'm pretty sure this is new, but it has been impacted. We'll have a closer look at that. Okay, well, this is interesting. We can see there's an impact here on the top there. It's very hard to get any sort of lighting there. That's the new one. As I said, I did replace a ball joint. It could have been this one. And I've got the other set to replace the other three. And I've got this one left over, which means that one was replaced in the past. But when I saw it, I thought that this here was a cut with a knife and it had been sabotaged, but there's also, that's an impact there. And around the back here, it's the same. It's just not reliable enough to be a spare car if there's a cut rubber cover. So I had to replace it, and so when I've looked into it, I see that the ball joint area has really suffered quite a hard impact. That's from removing it. So it was the swing arm frame and also around here, so I don't know, something's been run over and just hit up around that area. Okay, well, on with the new one. I'll remove this rubber jacket, put the grease in it like I always do. That compresses down a fair way, as we can see here. That was about down there. So, okay, I'll get on with it. Okay, well, there's the old ball joint. And that could have been done with the fork when I tried to remove it. However, that's sheared off. It was packed with grease. I could have packed with grease. I don't think this would be caused by grease that was packed too tightly. You know, because it's completely impacted and deformed. So what I'll do is I'll just put a bit more grease around the back of this. It won't move. At the moment, it's not worn in. So, okay, I'll get on with that. Okay, the new ball joint is now installed. All four bolts are done up. Okay, now I've got to start. Okay, well, I now realise, of course, that that damage there was caused by banging on the ball joint, so that's my bad. Yeah, have to be careful of that. Try and avoid hitting that area.